Hello students, our next topic is minor disorders during pregnancy and its management. Introduction. Many women experience some minor disorder during pregnancy. These disorders should be treated adequately as they may escalate and become life-threatening. Minor disorder may occur due to hormonal changes, accommodation changes, metabolic changes and postural changes. Every system and body may be affected by pregnancy. First is digestive system. Nausea, vomiting, constipation, acidity and heartburn, excessive salivation, abdominal discomfort and pica. First is nausea and vomiting. Especially in the morning soon after getting out of bed, usually common in primary gravida. 50% women have both nausea and vomiting, 25% have nausea only and 25% are unaffected. Most commonly occurs during the first 10 weeks, related to higher level of HCG. Management of nausea and vomiting. Dietary changes, behavioral modification, hospitalization may be necessary to correct fluid and electrolyte imbalance. Explanation and reassurance and symptomatic relief are sufficient. Avoid disagreeable odor and rich and spicy or greasy food. Drink water or other fluid between meals to avoid dehydration and acidity. Medication, well-known over-the-counter drug should be administered only when absolutely indicated and prescribed. Next is constipation, quite common element. Atonicity of gut due to effect of progesterone, diminished physical activity and pleasure of gravid uterus on the pelvic organ, sluggish bowel function are the possible explanation. Management is a regular bowel habit may be restored, emphasize ample fluid and laxative food and prescribed as a stool softener. Purgative should be avoided because of possibility of induced labor. Excessive and good bowel habit are helpful. Mineral oil is contraindicated because it absorbs fat soluble vitamin from the bowel and leak from the anus. Acidity and heartburn. Due to relaxation of the esophagus sphincter and hiatal hernia, heartburn result from gastroesophageal reflux disease is almost 10% of all gravidas. In late pregnancy, this may be aggravated by displacement of stomach and duodenum by the uterine fundus. Most likely to occur when the patient is lying down or bending over. Management, to avoid overeating and not to get bed immediately after the meal. Liquid antacid may be helpful. Sleeping in semi-reclined position with high pillow with hernia is reduced spontaneously after delivery. Symptomatic treatment, not surgery, is recommendation. Hot tea and changes of postural are helpful. Calcium containing antacid and histamine H2 receptor antagonist are pregnancy catalog to reduce gastric irritation. Next is excessive salivation or pitalism. Increased secretion of saliva observed during pregnancy. It is may be associated with increased intake of starch through actual causes is not unknown. Management. This problem is usually self-limiting and may be overcome by decreasing intake of carbohydrate. It is not associated with any adverse pregnancy outcome. Abdominal discomfort. Due to pressure, pelvic heaviness is caused by the weight of the uterus on the pelvic support and the abdominal wall. Round ligament tension, tenderness along the course of round ligament during late pregnancy is due to the traction on the structure by the uterus, which is displaced by the large bowel to be rotated slightly to the right. Fluctuations and distension can be due to large meals, gas-forming food, and chilled beverages. These are poorly tolerated by pregnant women. Management: rest frequently, preferable in the lateral position. Local heart and change of position. Dietary modification. Regular bowel function should be maintained, and exercise is beneficial. Acetaminophen 0.3 to 0.6 and 2 to 3 times daily may be valuable. Intra-abdominal discomfort should be diagnosed and treated appropriately. Next is pica. This is term used when the mother craved certain food or unnatural substance such as coal. The cause is unknown, but hormone and changes in metabolism are thought to contribute to this. If the substance craved and are harmful to the unborn baby, the mother must be helped to seek medical advice. And treatment is pica is iron, ठीक है, ferrous sulfate 100 mg BD and calcium tablet 500 mg BD and mebendazole 100 mg, ठीक है, into 3 days, और albendazole 400 mg state can be given for bone infestation. Next is musculoskeletal system. Musculoskeletal system is disorder is fatigue, backache, leg cramp, round ligament pain. सबसे पहले फैटी, द प्रेग्नेंट पेशेंट इज मोर सब्जेक्ट टू फैटिक ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट ट्राइमेस्टर ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी बिकॉज ऑफ अल्टर्ड पोस्चर एंड एक्स्ट्रा वेट कैरी. मैनेजमेंट इज एनीमिया एंड अदर सिस्टमेटिक डिजीज मस्ट बी रूल आउट. फ्रीक्वेंट रेस्ट पीरियड आर रिकमेंडेड. बैकएक कॉमन प्रॉब्लम 50% इन प्रेगनेंसी. फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंजेस that contribute to backache are joint ligament laxity, laxity estrogen, weight gain, hyperlordosis and anterior tilt of pelvis. May be due to faulty posture and high heel shoes, muscular spasm, urinary infection and constipation. Fatigue, muscle pain and postural back strain most often is responsible. Management of backache is excessive weight gain should be avoided. Rest with elevated of leg is flexed and hip may be helpful. Improvement of posture, well fitted pelvic girdle belt which correct the lumbar lordosis during walking and rest in hard bed. Improvement in posture is often achieved by wearing of low heel shoes. To achieve proper posture, the abdomen should be flattened, the pelvis tilt forward and the buttocks tucked under the sternum to back. Massaging the back muscles, analgesic and rest, back exercise under the supervision of rehabilitation physician and orthopedics or a physical therapist. Recommend sleep on a firm mattress. Apply local heat and light massage to relax tense taut back muscles. Give acetaminophen 0.3 to 0.6 gram orally or equivalent. Obtain orthopedic consultant if disability result. Note neurological sign symptom indicative for prolapsed intervertebral disc syndrome, yeah, radiculitis. Next is leg cramp. Quite common, usually in the leg, roast at night, and the cause of leg cramp in pregnancy is not known, but it may be due to deficiency vitamin B1 and of diffusible serum calcium or elevation of serum phosphorus. इट मे कोज टू इस्केमिया एंड चेंजेस इन पीएच और इलेक्ट्रोलाइट स्टेटस. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ लेग क्रैम्प्स इज सप्लीमेंट कैल्शियम थेरेपी इन टेबलेट और मील्स एंड कैल्शियम इन मील्स एंड मसाजिंग इन लेग्स एप्लीकेशन ऑफ लोकल हीट एंड इनटेक ऑफ विटामिन B1 30 mg डेली मे बी इफेक्टिव. स्लीप विद द फुट एंड एलिवेटेड बाय 20 to 25 cm वंस द क्रैम्प इज अकर जेंटली निकटिंग द इफेक्टिव. नेक्स्ट इज राउंड लिगामेंट पेन. स्ट्रेचिंग ऑफ द राउंड लिगामेंट ड्यूरिंग मूवमेंट इन प्रेगनेंसी में कॉज शार्प पेन इन ग्रोइन. द पेन मे बी यूनिलेटरल और बाइलेटरल. इट इज यूजली फेल्ट इन सेकेंड ट्राइमेस्टर ऑनवर्ड. दिस इज मोर कॉमन इन राइट साइड एज द रिजल्ट ऑफ डेक्सरो रोटेशन ऑफ यूट्रस. पेन मे बी अवॉकनिंग एट द नाइट टाइम बिकॉज ऑफ सडन रोल ओवर मूवमेंट ड्यूरिंग स्लीप. मैनेजमेंट. पेन मे बी रिड्यूस बाय मेकिंग मूवमेंट ग्रेजुअली इंस्टेड ऑफ सडन. लोकल हीट एप्लीकेशन इज हेल्पफुल. एनाल्जेसिक आर रेयरली नीडेड. नेक्स्ट इज सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. वेरिकोज वेन, हेमरॉइड्स, सिनकोप एंड एंकल इडिमा. नेक्स्ट इज फर्स्ट वन इज वेरिकोज वेन. इन द लेग वल्वा वेरिकोसाइट्स और रेक्टल हेमरॉइड्स में अपियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम और एग्रीवेटेड ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी. यूजुअली इन द लेटर मंथ ड्यू टू ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इन द वीनस रिटर्न बाय द प्रेगनेंट यूट्रस. ड्यू टू स्मूथ मसल्स रिलैक्सेशन वीकनेस ऑफ द वास्कुलर वॉल एंड इम्पोर्टेंट वॉल. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ वेरिकोज वेन. द लेग वेरिकोसाइटिस इलास्टिक क्रैम्प बैंडेज मूवमेंट एंड एलिवेशन ऑफ लिम्ब ड्यूरिंग रेस्ट कैन बी सिम्टोमेटिक रिलीफ. एलिवेटेड लेग अबव द लेवल ऑफ हर बॉडी एंड कंट्रोल एक्सेसिव वेट गेन. अवॉइड फोर्सफुल मसाज स्पेशली डाउनवर्ड दैट इज अगेंस्ट वीनस रिटर्न एंड पॉइंट प्रेशर ओवर द लेग. इन मोर सीवियर लेग एंड वल्वुलर वेरिकोसाइटिस हाउएवर ए जॉब्स टाइप री ली ओट गारमेंट्स मे बी नेसेसरी टू ऑब्टेन वीनस कंप्रेशन. इंजेक्शन और सर्जिकल करेक्शन ऑफ वेरिकोज वेन यूजली इज नॉट रिकमेंडेड ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी. नेक्स्ट इज हेमरॉइड्स. इट मे कॉज एनोइंग कॉम्प्लिकेशन लाइक ब्लीडिंग और मे गेट प्रोलैप्स्ड. मे अकर कंसिडरेबल डिस्कम्फर्ट. स्ट्रेनिंग एट स्टूल ऑफन कॉज हेमरॉइड्स स्पेशली इन वुमेन प्रोन टू वेरिकोसाइटिस. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ हेमरॉइड्स. रेगुलर यूज ऑफ लेग्जेटिव. लोकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ हाइड्रोकोर्टिसोल ऑइंटमेंट. सर्जिकल ट्रीटमेंट इज बेटर टू बी विदहेल्ड एज ए कंडीशन इम्प्रूव फॉलोइंग डिलीवरी. ट्रीट कॉन्स्टिपेशन अर्ली. डू नॉट सूचर. सिट्स बाथ. रेक्टल ऑइंटमेंट सपोजिटरी एंड माइल्ड लेग्जेटिव आर इंडिकेट पोस्ट ऑपरेटिवली और पोस्ट डिलीवरी. इंजेक्शन ट्रीटमेंट आर कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड. नेक्स्ट इज सिनकोप या फेंटनेस. द वुमन प्रेजेंट द डिजीनेस और लाइट हेडेक और ऑन स्टैंडिंग अपराइट अब्रुप्ट ऑन फॉलोइंग स्टैंडिंग फॉर ए प्रोलोंग्ड पीरियड. फॉलोइंग प्रोलोंग्ड स्टैंडिंग और स्टैंडिंग अपराइट अब्रप्टली. ड्यू टू पूलिंग ऑफ ब्लड इन द वेन ऑफ द लोअर एक्सट्रीमिटी एंड कंप्रेशन ऑफ द पेल्विक वेन बाय ग्रेविड यूट्रस. अदर कॉज मे बी डिहाइड्रेशन पॉलीग्लाइसीमिया और ओवर एक्सर्शन. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ सिनकोप्स. सिनकोप्स यूजली रिजोल्व रैपिडली ऑन लाइंग इन लेफ्ट लेटरल पोजिशन. सिनकोप्स इन सुपाइन पोजिशन इज ऑल्सो मैनेज बाई रेस्टिंग इन लेटरल रिकमेंड पोजिशन. रिकरेंट सिनकोप नीड कार्डियोलॉजिकल इवेलुएशन. एनकरेज द पेशेंट टू ईट 6 स्मॉल मील इन ए डे रादर देन 3 लार्ज वंस. स्टिमुलेट स्प्रिच ऑफ एमोनिया कॉफी टी आर इंडिकेटेड फॉर अटैक्स ड्यू टू पोस्टुरल हाइपोटेंशन. Next is ankle edema. Evidence by marked gain in weight or evidence of preeclampsia develops in at least 2/3 of women in late pregnancy due to water retention and increased venous pressure in leg. Generalized edema always serious must be investigated. Management. No treatment is required for physiological edema or orthostatic edema. Edema subside on rest with slight elevation of leg. Diuretics should not be prescribed. Treatment is largely prevented and symptomatic. The patient should elevate her leg frequently. Restrict excessive salt intake and provide elastic support for varicose vein. Diuretics may reduce edema temporarily but may be harmful to the mother or fetus. Next is nervous system. Insomnia, headache, carpal tunnel syndrome. First one is insomnia. It is relatively common in late pregnancy owing to the discomfort causing by fetal movement, frequently of micturition, difficulty in finding and a comfortable position. It may also due to some deep-seated anxiety or fear. Management. Take rest in the afternoon. Drink a glass of warm milk at bedtime. Tuck a pillow under the abdomen when lying in a lateral position. Talk about her fear, anxiety so that she can have a sense of normal and lightness. Headache. Headache is in pregnancy is common and usually due to tension. Retractive error and ocular imbalance are not caused by normal pregnancy. Several persistent headache in the third trimester may be regarded as symptomatic of preeclampsia, eclampsia until proven otherwise. Next is carpal tunnel syndrome. Pain and numbness in thumb, index and middle finger. Weakness in the muscles of thumb movement due to compression effect of medial nerve. Physiological changes in pregnancy with the retention of excessive fluid are common cause. Management. Treatment is mostly symptomatic. The splint is applied during sleep time to the slightly flexed wrist to give relief. Corticosteroid injection or surgical decompression is rarely needed. It resolves spontaneously following delivery. Next is genitourinary system. Vaginal discharge, leukorrhea and urinary symptoms. First one is vaginal discharges. Management, assurance to the patient and advice for local cleanliness are required. Presence of any infection, trichomonas, candida, bacterial vaginosis should be treated with vaginal application of metronidazole or miconazole. Next is leukorrhea. Gradually increase in amount of non-irritating vaginal discharge due to estrogen stimulation of cervical mucus is normal during pregnancy. Such vaginal fluid is milky, thin, non-irritating unless infection has occurred. Persistent external moisture due to mucus may be cause mild pruritus, but itching is rarely several without infection. Management is reassurance the patient, suggest protective perineal pad, excessive leukorrhea accompanied by pruritus or discoloration of secretion may indicate bleeding or infection requiring treatment. Next is urinary symptoms. Urinary frequency, urgency, stress, incompetence and multipara are common, especially urinary symptoms. Urinary frequency, urgency and stress incontinence in multiparous are common, especially in advanced pregnancy. Due to increased intra-abdominal pressure, reduced bladder capacity. suspected urinary tract in disease if dysuria or hematuria are present. Management: when urgency is particularly troublesome, limit caffeine, spices and popular beverages, and eight glasses of cranberry juices assist in both maintaining urinary acidity as well as decreasing urinary tract infection. Respiratory symptoms: breathlessness, not actually dyspnea, is a progesterone effect. In non-smokers and other free of cough or allergic problem, breathlessness occurs as early as the 12th week of pregnancy, and most women have these symptoms by the 30 week. Management: there is no effective management. Next is integumentary system. Skin: some mother complained the generalized itching, which often start over the abdomen, due to have some connection with the liver's response to the hormones is pregnancy and with raised bilirubin level. Management of itching: it clears soon after the baby is born, and discomfort can be gained from local application, and antihistamines is often prescribed if a mother complained of vulval irritation. Infection such as thrush and glycosuria as a result of diabetes must be excluded. Washing with mild soap and cotton underwear might help to ease the irritation. Disorder that require immediate action: vaginal bleeding, reduced fetal movement, frontal and recurrent headache, sudden swelling, edema, rupture of membrane, premature onset of contraction, sudden nausea and sickness, and epigastric pain. Okay, thank you.